This is a PACCAR Powertrain Knowledge Minute on valve adjustment. This video covers PACCAR MX13 EPA 2010 only. This includes model years 2010 through 2012.
RMI is
the only source for up-to-date, accurate information on the valve adjustment process, as well as other maintenance and repair processes. For safety reasons, and also to protect electronic components during the valve adjustment process, begin by disconnecting the batteries. The process begins by removing the valve cover. The first step of doing this is to clean the dust and debris from around the valve cover itself. If the air cleaner has already been removed, make sure that all air induction openings are capped. Remove any pipes, brackets, or attachments necessary to remove the valve cover. Then remove the bolts and the valve cover. One of the PACCAR MX engine special tools is the 1903-018 engine cranking tool. This should be used to align the appropriate marks on the flywheel for adjusting the valves. On this engine, the crankshaft will have to be rotated 6 times in 120-degree increments to adjust all the valves. There are 3 stop positions on the flywheel and front pulley related to adjusting the valves. These are 1-6, 2-5, and 3-4. You can position the crank in any of these 3 positions to start the valve adjustment process. Once you stop on a mark, you need to adjust the valves for whichever of the 2 cylinders has no open valves. The adjustment for both the intake and exhaust on the EPA 2010 MX13 is made between the foot of the rocker arm and the top of the valve bridge. The adjustment is made using the adjusting screw and lock nut on the valve bridge end of the rocker. Select the intake valve rocker and check the clearance. Refer to PACCAR MX service documentation for the correct clearance specification. Since a small amount of residual oil between the rocker and the valve bridge, or between the rocker and the push tube, can affect the measurement, be sure to toggle the rocker before making the measurement. If adjustment is required, loosen the lock nut, and with the Allen wrench, loosen or tighten the adjusting screw as needed. Be sure to check the adjustment each time you move either the adjusting screw or the lock nut. Even though you take care to make sure there is no movement, small movements can affect accuracy. As this video is being produced, the torque is 64 Newton meters, or 47 foot-pounds. However, you should always check for updates to any torque spec in Rapido. The adjustment point for both the intake valve and the exhaust valve is between the rocker foot and the valve bridge. Once the exhaust valve is adjusted, it is time to reinstall the valve cover. Clean the mating surface between the cylinder head and the valve cover. Also clean the gasket retention groove in the valve cover. It is strongly recommended that a new valve cover gasket be installed after each valve adjustment. This valve adjustment service interval is fairly long. Reinstall the new valve cover, making sure not to pinch anything under the valve cover or do anything that damages the new gasket. Run the valve cover bolts down gently, evenly, and snugly. You can do this by hand or with a power tool. But remember, the final tightening must be done with a torque wrench. At the time of production of this video, the final torque on the valve cover should be about 9 Newton meters. This is 80 inch-pounds or 6.6 foot-pounds. Be sure to check PACCAR powertrain documentation before you start the job to determine if this spec has changed. Now reinstall and reconnect all the brackets, lines, and hoses that needed to be removed in order to remove the valve cover. If the air cleaner assembly was removed, make sure that it is installed properly and leak-free. As a final step in the process, reconnect the batteries. It is recommended that you follow the truck manufacturer's recommendation on the torque spec for the battery connections.